Hello friends, my dear students, myself Vandri Sheetal from Rayat Shikshan Sanstas Rao Bahadur Narayan Rao Borauke College, Sirampur. This video is prepared under the guidance and support of Honorable Principal Dr. Gaikwad Sahib. In this video, here we are going to discuss about the well-developed cell organelles of the eukaryotic cell, that is the structure of the mitochondria and structure of the chloroplast is there. How these cell organelles they are working, how their structure is that, and which are the elements present in these cell organelles, that we are going to show here one by one. Now come towards the first here, this diagram is showing the structure of the mitochondria. As we know that here the eukaryotes, they are the well developed cell how showing, and the plant and animal cell only differentiate on the basis of the cell wall as well as the presence of the chloroplast. This mitochondria here is nothing but we called it as a powerhouse of a cell, because it generates the energy in the form of the ATP, and here the totally the process of aerobic respiration is under the control and working of this mitochondria. How this mitochondria, it shows the structure here. The diagrammatically here it shows that it is the double membranous structure. The outer membrane, it is in the continuation, as well as here the inner membrane is get the folded, and this folding, it is shows here the presence of the particles. They are showing the dot like structures which are observed in this diagram. These particles, they are called as oxysomes, F1 particles or the Fernandez particles. Along with that here, the internally the matrix is present. That matrix, it contains the ribosomes and the mitochondrial DNA is there. Okay, now here that the inner membrane, it is get enclosed and folded, and the outer membrane, it is the permeable membrane. Here due to this the permeability, it allows the flow of the substances from the surrounding cell is there. Here that matrix, it contains the various elements are there, and just like the cytoplasm, here that matrix, it will be get working. This mitochondria, it contains the ribosomes, but these ribosomes, it is of the primitive, means the which are present in this prokaryotic cell. That type of ribosomes are present here, that is of the 70S type of the ribosome is present. And the during this Krebs cycle here, that mitochondria follows the various biochemical reactions. This mitochondria, though it is present in the eukaryotic cell, here this mitochondria, it shows the presence of its self DNA, that is known as a mitochondrial DNA. And here due to presence of this mitochondrial DNA, that cell organelle, it is known as a self replicating cell organelle, because due to presence of the DNA, they are having the capacity to get divide, and therefore they are called as a semi autonomous or self replicating cell organelle. Now here come towards the oxysomes, elementary particles or the F1 particles, or we call them as a Fernandez particles. Here this oxysome, when that will be get enlarged here, this shows the three regions. The magnified portion of these F1 particles, this shows the head region, stalk region, as well as here the base region. Now here these oxysomes, they are working in the ATP synthesis. That process, the formation of the ATP, that will be takes place, and the pumping of the ATP synthesis, it will be occurred. That is, we can say that here these oxysomes, they are the site for the production of the energy in the form of ATP. And no doubt here the main function of these mitochondria is nothing but to generate the energy in the form of the ATP, and therefore we called it as a powerhouse of a cell. Now here come towards the another cell organelle, that is the chloroplast, or the that structure, it is under the heading of the plastid. Now, what are these plastids? Here, like the mitochondria, these plastids, they are also the double membranous cell organelles, and these double membranous cell organelles, it contains about the DNA, RNA, as well as the 70S type of the ribosome. It is large in size and it can be observed under the light microscope also. These plastids, they are get classified into presence of the pigment. They are the leucoplast, chloroplast and the chromoplast. Here, these three types of the plastids are there. That these leucoplast, they will be called as the colorless plastid because they does not contain any pigment. And here, due to absence of the pigment, that leucoplast, it is called as the colorless plastid. They also having the various shapes and size. They are for the storage of the nutrient. For example, here the amyloplast that store the starch, the ileoplast that store the oil, alleuroplast that store the proteins. The chromoplast, they contains here the pigment like the carotene, xanthophyll. Due to this here, the yellow or orange color, it will be get appear to the fruits, seeds, flowers because of this pigmentation. Here, these leucoplast and amyloplast, they contains the absence of the photosynthetic apparatus, and here this photosynthetic apparatus, it is present only in the chloroplast pigment. The plant cell, that is the algae, some protists, euglena, they contains the chloroplast and they can be observed under the microscope. As we know that here these are the primitive organisms. The chlamydomonas, it is also here the simple organism, and here only it contains the very primitive green color structure. Chloroplast is present in this chlamydomonas. Near about only 20 to 40 chloroplast, they are present in the mesophyll cell. That chloroplast, it contains the pigment chlorophyll, and here due to presence of this pigment chlorophyll, here the plant's leaves, they are appearing as a green in color. Along with this chlorophyll pigment, here the some xanthophyll, the beta carotene pigments, these pigments, they are also responsible to give the coloration to the plants. Here the some brown algae, they are referred or they are get follows, that is the pigment that gives because of the brown color. Okay, now here come towards that structure of a chloroplast. Here this diagram, it shows the ultra microscopic structure of the chloroplast. Again here the outer membrane, inner membrane, here the two membranes are present. It is also the membrane bound cell organelles. Inside here the matrix is present, just like that cytoplasm. The matrix, it refers as the ground substances to this chloroplast. Again here that chloroplast, it contains the primitively, means the 70S types of the ribosomes are there. Now this chloroplast, it contains here the coin like structure which are get arranged one above the another, and singly they are, we called them as this thylakoids. Here that structure, it is known as a thylakoids, and here these thylakoids, they are get arranged in the form of the stack, just like the coins if are get arranged on one another, that structure is look like that, and that structure togetherly we called as a grana, and singularly we called it as a granum. These grana, they are interconnected by each other through a membranous tubule. That here, that all these grana in this matrix, they are not separated, they are get connected to each other, And here they are get connected through the structure. We call them it as a stroma lamellae. Here, with the help of these stroma lamellae, these grana, they are connected. The space outside the thylakoid, it is get filled with this stroma. That stroma and the space inside the thylakoid that contains the various enzymes, and these enzymes, they are responsible here for the process of the photosynthesis. Just like the other plastid, that stroma, it contains the chloroplast and also contains the DNA. Now again, this chloroplast, it is known as a self-replicating cell organelle because they are having their own DNA. Now come towards here, the structure of the ribosome. As we have seen, or we know that the two types of the cells are there, that is prokaryotic and eukaryotic. And here on the basis of this, these prokaryotic cell, they follows the primitively 70S types of the ribosome, and this eukaryotic cell, they shows the 80S types of the ribosomes are there. These ribosomes, that S, it stands for the Swedberg's unit is there. Here, that S means here the Swedberg's unit, and these large subunit and small subunit, they are made up of the singly structure of the ribosome. In these 70S here, the 30S and 50S, that 30S it is the small subunit and 50S it is the large subunit is there. In this 80S here, 40S it is the small subunit and 60S it is the large subunit is present. Now in this eukaryotic cell here, these ribosomes, they are present in mitochondria, plastids, cytosol also, and these ribosomes in the cytoplasm, they are maybe the free or may be attached to the endoplasmic reticulum, and they are the freely one end is get attached to the nucleus and another end get attached to the cell wall, or may be the freely suspended in the cytoplasm. Both are similar in structure, are of the 80 and 70s, that each ribosome, it is responsible to produce the proteins that are transported outside the cell after the processing in endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi complex. Here, the example bound ribosomes of the SNR cell of pancreas, they produce the pancreatic digestive enzyme and free ribosome together and form a chain that is called here the polyribosome, as well as here the protein synthesis. The very important only is that here the ribosomes are, they are generally responsible for the protein synthesis. Now here, this is about the structure of the three cell organelles, that is the mitochondria, chloroplast, and here the ribosomes are there. This mitochondria, we called it as a powerhouse of a cell. These chloroplast here, due to presence of the pigment green color, they are appearing, or the all the leaves, they are appearing in green color. And here these grana or thylakoid region, they are nothing but the site of the photosynthesis where the pigment systems are get working. And these ribosomes 70 and 80S type, they are responsible for the protein synthesis. They may be get attached to endoplasmic reticulum or may be the freely present in the cytoplasm. Okay, thank you.